In this video, we're doing a couple basic definite integrals that result in natural logs. And so the fundamental theorem of calculus says to get a definite integral, I just have to guess the antiderivative of the integrand and evaluate across the limits of integration. And I'll leave this for another video, but the antiderivative of 1 over x is the natural log of the absolute value of x. And those absolute value bars matter. Those are going to make a difference in the second example here. In the first example, when I evaluate across the limits of integration, both of those numbers are positive, so the absolute value doesn't really do anything there. And the first term is natural log of e, which is 1, and the second term is natural log of 1, which is 0, and this comes out to 1. What about the second example? So I'm getting the area bounded by 1 over x from x equals negative 2 to negative 1. I guess the antiderivative of the integrand. And now the absolute value bars are critical because the natural log of a negative number is undefined. Well, good thing we have those absolute value bars. And this becomes the natural log of 1 minus the natural log of 2. And the natural log of 1 vanishes. And I get a final signed area of negative natural log 2. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left. Or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.